Hello and good evening. This is Ruth Pasola from Curbal.com, and today I want to talk about variables in DAX. Why they're useful, how to use them, and what are the benefits of actually doing that. So to demonstrate it, we are going to use our well-known growth dashboard. For those of you that haven't seen it before, this is a Google Analytics dashboard that measures the growth of a site. And some of the formulas here, they look quite complicated. They are not that complicated, but you know, when you see this, they just look absolutely, you know, daunting. So one of the things that variables can do for us is just help us write this in a manner that is more readable, and then it will be more useful and easier to maintain. So what this is doing, month to yesterday, what it does is it calculates the number of sessions that you had on the website this month up to yesterday's date. So today is the 11th of July, it says here, and from the 11th of July to yesterday, I had 13 sessions in this site. So there is a problem with the measure. Don't know if I would say really a problem, but when the date of the month is the first of the month and is equal to today's date, this calculation broke. So what I had to do was basically to have an if statement that said, if today's date is the first day of the month, then do this thing instead of what you were doing. And what it came out, it was it looks a quite complicated formula. So let's write some variables to clean this up and make it more useful, or like easier to read. So first of all, syntax for the variable is you write the variable name and then you write what these things should do. And then you write return. And then here, you just, for example, can write the name of the variable. Just said, okay, give me back that. Or normally you will have like, add this with this, or if something is A, do C plus D, or whatever it is. So let's go back to our report, so I'll demonstrate how it looks like. So what we're going to do is you have to press Alt Enter to create a space. I showed these tricks on how to create Power BI DAX, or how to write Power BI DAX fast video. So I will give you a link in case you haven't seen it, because it will help you write better formulas. So what you do is you write var, and then you write the name of the variable. This is it will give us the second month date. I won't write that. And the formula that does that is this calculate. So let's bring that up. We take that, Control X. We put it in there. And you don't press enter, you press Alt Enter. Okay, so now we have a variable that is called second month that gives us the date from last month. This is wrong. We get there, Alt Enter. There you go. Now we're going to write our other variable. You can write as many variables as you like, or as you need. First month equal, and now we're going to get the other calculate. which is in there. So Alt Enter, and then we copy that calculator there, and this will give us the date when today's month is not the first day of the month. And now we stay there. Alt Enter, and we write return. So, and what it will return is the actual if condition. So if today date is the first day of the month, then give us second month. Otherwise, give us first month. So isn't this easier to understand? I think it's much easier. You still have to think about, okay, what this calculate formula is doing, what is this other calculate formula, but you still see, okay, this calculates something, and then if something happens, then this or this. You could not really see that on the way we were writing the formula before. This is the way it looked like, because this is a similar one. You see, it's completely impossible to see what's going on. This is much clearer. Another good thing is that you can actually reuse these variables anywhere else in the same report, and you can use variables for tables. So start using variables, extremely useful, and it will make your calculations so much easier to write and to understand. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like it, please let me know. And if you have questions, you can let me know in the comment box or just contact me on the website. Please subscribe. I publish the video around once a week, sometimes a little bit more. Have a great evening. Bye.